إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهد الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الواحد الأحد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمين وعلى آل بيته الأطهار وصحابته الكرام وتابعيهم والتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated to Medina, Abdullah ibn Salam, who was at that time a Jewish leader in Medina, said when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to Medina, people of Medina went to the outskirts of the city to receive him. And Abdullah ibn Salam was curious, wanted to know if this Prophet is for real or he is a fake prophet. And you know the Prophet was described vividly in the Torah and the Old Testament. So he decided to go with, you know, the group of people. And he said, when I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I knew right away that this face is not a face of a liar. عرفت في أن هذا الوجه ليس بوجه كذاب. And Abdullah ibn Salam became a Muslim, and he said, the first thing I heard the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying as he was entering Medina, he was saying this hadith. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, remember, I just want you to understand the background of the whole concept and the whole situation and environment at that moment. Prophet Muhammad was leaving Mecca, right? After 13 years of aggression against him and his da'wah and his companions. And the moment he arrives in Medina and people receive him, regular people would just take an opportunity, an advantage of that situation to complain about what happened to them yesterday. Prophet Muhammad was not sent for that. He was sent to build a loving, strong society to spread this deen. So he was looking at tomorrow, not yesterday. He said, أيها الناس, أفشوا السلام. وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا الأرحام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام تدخلوا الجنة بسلام. Four simple reminders. When we, I'm sure each and every one of us probably remember or memorize this hadith. But this hadith, brothers and sisters, sums together how a society should be. So what does Afsh al-Salam would do to any community? There is another hadith explain this, brothers and sisters. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, لَا تَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى تُؤْمِنُوا. Let me just go back to the hadith and say it in English. Forgive me, brothers and sisters. I said the hadith in Arabic. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he entered Medina, said, Afsh al-Salam, spread the greeting of peace. وَأَطْعِمُ الطَّعَامُ, and feed the needy. وَصِلُوا الْأَرْحَامُ, and maintain the relationship of your kin. وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامُ, and offer a prayer at night when you are alone, by yourself, between you and your Lord, you will enter paradise in peace. So I'm explaining the first one, أَفْشُ السَّلَامُ, what does it mean to any community? What does spreading the greeting of peace, السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ, would do to any community? Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in another hadith, لا تدخلون الجنة حتى تؤمنوا. You will not enter paradise until you complete the faith, until you master your faith. ولا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا. You will not master the faith until you love one another. That love has to exist, because the love will push. There will be no vacuum for hate. ولا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا أولا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم And you will not master the faith until you love one another. Should I direct you to something? If you do, you will love one another. أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ. That will ensure that we... And when you see a brother, brothers and sisters, when you see a brother, you have to face him with a smile on your face. Our deen is a deen of happiness, not a deen of sadness and seriousness. Sometimes we think that I have to have that, you know, posture of being serious and mad to show that I'm a real Muslim, a true Muslim. It is even sadaqah to see your to face your brother with a smiley face. So offer that greeting of peace so we can love one another. The second reminder, وَأَطْعِمُ الطَّعَامُ. Offer the food to the needy. Because in every society, this group of people exist. You know, I went through the Quran, and you can find throughout, across the Quran, reminders and calls to care for those who are in need, and to give for the sake of God, and to give you zakah, and to give you sadaqat. But when I was reading Surah Al-Insan, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a title to a group of people, called them al-abrar. This is a title, brothers and sisters. And it's not any title. You know, in this dunya, you probably would work 5 years or 10 years to get a title. From maybe a representative into a manager, into a director, into, you know, a vice president. And you would be proud that you get a new title. And you want people to greet you or say congratulations to you because you got a new title. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given this group of people the title of al-abrar. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. The righteous shall drink from a cup. The mixture is of kamfur. عَيْنًا يَشْرَبُ بِهَا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ. It is a fountain that the servants of Allah shall drink from it. They will let it flow forth. يُفَجِّرُونَهَا تَفْجِيرًا. Who are they? يُوفُونَ بِالنَّذْرِ. They fulfill their vows. وَيَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا كَانَ شَرُّهُ مُسْتَطِيرًا. And they fear the severity of the day of judgment. What else? وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. And they feed for the love of God. طبعا there are two translations to this verse. For the love of, despite the love of food or for the love of God, I would go for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For only for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second ayah explains that. And they feed for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the needy, the captive, and the orphans. They say it right away, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. We only feed you for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Allah. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We are not expecting anything in return from you. No recognition, not even a word of thanks. Why? They want it to be purely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their relationship is, I deal with you, I help you, but I expect the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from you. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ وَلَقَّاهُمْ نَضْرَةً وَسُرُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the answer right away. When they said, we only feed you for the sake of God because we fear the severity of the day of judgment. We want to put something forth for ourselves when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the answer right away. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ. Allah protected them from the severity, the evil of that day. وَلَقَّاهُمْ نَضْرَةً وَسُرُورًا. He put beauty and smiles, happiness on their faces. When everyone is frowning and waiting to see if he or she is gonna receive the book in their right hand or their left hand, Allah put smiles and happiness on the faces of those al-abrar. that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to be among them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of us to be among al-abrar. Allahumma ameen. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهِ Allah protected from them the severity of the day of judgment. وَلَقَاهُمْ نَدْرَةً وَسُرُورًا What else? وَجَزَاهُمْ بِمَا صَبَرُوا جَنَّةً وَحَرِيرًا And because they were patient, they were doing what they're doing, not expecting, right, with humbleness, not expecting anything in this dunya, believing in their heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the ultimate reward. This is the complete faith, brothers and sisters. وَجَزَاهُمْ بِمَا صَبَرُوا جَنَّةً وَحَرِيرًا And that's the ultimate prize. When we have that complete faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's the answer to that. وَصِلُوا الْأَرْحَامِ The third reminder. Maintain the relationship of your kin. Brothers and sisters, the family العائلة هي أس المجتمع. The family is the cornerstone of any community and society. What is a community? What is a society? A community or a society is just a number of families. That's what it is. A strong family means a strong community. And a weak family, broken family, means a broken community. That's why Islam told us that we have to take care of our kin. We have to make sure that we have that strong family, great relationship between ourselves. And Silat al-Raham, brothers and sisters, I'm going to sum it in one, as the Prophet ﷺ said it. You know, you have brother, you have sister, you have cousin, and you have this, and you say, you know, you call your brother one time or your sister one time, and you go visit them, and they don't visit you back. And then you visit them again, and they don't visit you back. And you visit them again, and they don't visit back. And you say, enough is enough. I visited them 3 times, 5 times, and they don't visit me back. I'm not going again. The Prophet ﷺ said, this is not Silat Arham. This is not the Silat Rahim. You know what is this? This is one for one. You want to visit and expect to be visited. You want to call and expect to be called. You want to say hello and expect to be said hello to you. This is one for one. Silat al-Rahim, brothers and sisters, يدخل فيها الإحسان. إحسان. Silat al-Rahim is built on إحسان, meaning I visit without expecting anything back in return. Without expecting them to visit me back. Just like feeding the needy. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ We visit you also لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ For the sake of God. We're not expecting you to visit us back at all. And the fourth reminder, وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامٌ And at the end of the day, offer a prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you're just between you and Him, you can't fake it, you can't master it, you know, because, you know, so people can say that you're a great, you know, you're doing prayer, your prayer in the best way possible. You're alone. Look at this hadith, brothers. This is a very simple hadith. But if you dig deep in this hadith is like a triangle. The bottom of the triangle is everyone in the community, everyone in the society, and we have to offer them, build that love and compassion between us in the community. That's the bottom, this is the whole community. Then as you go with the pyramid, a smaller portion, a smaller group of people, those who are in need in our community, and we have to care for them. Then as you go up the pyramid, a smaller group, which is the family, and you have to maintain it. And at the top of the pyramid is yourself and myself. And I still also have to care for myself. So each and every one of us has that pyramid of responsibility for your community and your society. And if each and every one of us does it fully and takes care of it, and practice it every day, guess what? We're gonna have a healthy, strong, compassionate, loving society. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي ومن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله على آله وصحبه ومن سار على هديه ثم بعد. Brothers and sisters, the Muslim Ummah
In today's world, the whole world is a small village. And yes, I probably live in a community, in this community, in Dar al-Hijra community, or in Alexandria community, or in New Jersey community. But as a Muslim ummah, wherever they are, it is still my community. And maybe I can't say assalamu alaikum to them, but I can do something else for them. I can pray for them, and I can also take care of their needy. I am today, brothers and sisters, representing Bayt al-Mal, an organization that takes care of the needy around the world. And I'm going to talk to you about Lebanon. And you might say, Lebanon? Yes, brothers and sisters. When we mention Africa, everybody thinks, yes, there is poverty in Africa. Every time I mention Palestine, they say, yes, Palestine is in desperate need for help. But when we mention a country that's not in the news, you know, people start questioning, what's in Lebanon? More than 80% today, brothers and sisters, I was listening to the news last week, the poverty went up from 40% to 82% in Lebanon. People can't find food, they can't find medicine, they can't find anything to support themselves. And especially those who live in refugee camps, the Palestinians in the refugee camps, the Syrians in the refugee camps, and the poor communities in Lebanon, and there's so many, by the way. Don't look at Beirut. Go to the north. Go to Trablus and after Trablus and Akkar. Go to the south in Saida. Go to Wadi Khalid, and you can see the poverty in Lebanon. Brothers and sisters, Bayt al-Mal is planning to send medicine because people cannot find medicine in Lebanon. So, alhamdulillah, in Ramadan, we sent about 3,000 food packages to Lebanon alone. That's more than what we sent to any other country around the world. But now we want to send medicine. Alhamdulillah, we're in the talks of providing medical beds also to the hospitals and in Lebanon, and we're going to provide some medicine, inshallah ta'ala. We provided some medical equipments in Lebanon, alhamdulillah, about 2 months ago, and it was distributed to so many clinics and hospitals. Alhamdulillah, that was a great accomplishment. But now we want to provide medicine that they need desperately, brothers and sisters. And also, if we want to sponsor their orphans, the door is open. But I really, really ask you, brothers and sisters, this is an opportunity for us to show that we really care about our brothers and sisters, regardless where they are located. And people of Lebanon today, they are in desperate need for your help. So I really ask you, in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to break all these ethnicities and let us come as a community today and say, yes, today is today for Lebanon. Maybe tomorrow is tomorrow, a day for Palestine, or maybe for the Myanmar, or every day let it be for another community. But today is for Lebanon, and I really ask you, brothers and sisters, the same way every Friday, we sit for 15, 20 minutes, half an hour, for the sake of God, we don't move. I ask you also for the sake of God, also for the sake of God, and only for the sake of God, to stay for another 3 to 5 minutes after Jumu'ah. And you say, we only sit in for the sake of God, so we can make a difference in the lives of so many brothers and sisters. I've been to Lebanon. I've been 3 times, and the last time I was probably last year when after the explosion, and I went to communities, and I was shocked to see such communities in desperate need, you know, in a country that is living between us. And we think, you know, when we mention Lebanon, we mention, you know, but today, brothers and sisters, Lebanon is in need, just like Palestine is in need, just like Syria and Yemen is in need. But we want to dedicate this day for Lebanon, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable all of us, all of us to take part in this and to make a difference and to only make that difference لوجه الله لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين اللهم أصلح فساد قلوبنا اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه أرنا اللهم الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم احفظ لنا أبناءنا وأزواجنا بما تحفظ به عبادك الصالحين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب اللهم أعنا على قضاء حوائج المحتاجين اللهم أعنا على قضاء حوائج المحتاجين اللهم كن للمستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها يا رب العالمين غير حالهم إلى أحسن حال اللهم غير حالهم إلى أحسن حال اللهم قنا شر يوم القيامة يا رب العالمين اللهم قنا شر يوم القيامة يا رب العالمين واجعلنا ممن تدخلهم الجنة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم آمين اللهم آمين وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وأنت يا أخي أقم الصلاة.